In this instructional video, we will cover how to analyze your lab number one data. You should watch this video after you have defined all of your variables and entered all participant data into SPSS. If you saved your data file and tried to reopen it, but don't see any of your data, no worries. Click on the Open Folder icon. Locate your data file. Make sure that under Files of Type, it says PASWStatistics.sav. That will tell the computer to allow you to open this kind of SPSS file. Click on the file and then hit Open. Open up your completed data file and make sure you are in the data view window. Glance over the data to make sure there are no mistakes. Descriptive statistics describe the characteristics of a data set or sample. In this case scenario, the descriptive statistics that you are telling SPSS to calculate describe the characteristics of your sample of parents at the middle school. To run descriptive statistics, go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Frequencies. All of the variables in your database are visible in the box to the left. A ruler symbol indicates a continuous scale level measurement. Three rings is a symbol for nominal level variable. And three rings with a subscript A indicates a qualitative variable where participants answered in their own words an open-ended question. First, click on the scale level variables and move them over to the right-hand box by clicking on the arrow between the left and the right box. Once the scale level variable is moved to the right box, click Statistics. In the Statistics box, check mark Mean Median Mode, as well as Standard Deviation under Dispersion. Then click Continue. Then click OK. Do not include participant ID in your analysis of central tendency. You will now see the start of your output screen. An output file gives you the results of your analysis. And you will use this screen to get your information about how your participants answered the questions. In each variable's chart, the frequency is your lowercase n. And under valid percent, we'll give you info about the percent of people who answered each response in each item on the survey. Here, the output file gives you descriptive information about how your parents answered the first item on the survey in terms of central tendency and frequency of responses. You should keep a copy of this file on your computer because this is one of the files required to submit for grading of your lab assignments. It is important to note that the output file with extension SPV is different from your SPSS data file with extension SAV. Be sure to save your output file since it is a separate file from your SPSS database. Go ahead and save as first to save to your desktop. For example, if your name is Gary Smith, go up to Save As and save this file with the name and lab number, if this is lab number 1, as Gary Smith underscore lab 1 underscore output. Now you have saved this output file on your desktop. And remember, the output file is different from the SPSS data file. Keep in mind, you will need to submit both of these files for your lab number 1 assignment. Next, we are going to run descriptive statistics on the items with ordinal and nominal level variables. Go back up to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Frequencies. We first need to move the scale level variables back to the list so that they are not run again on the output page. Highlight the scale variable that is currently in the right box and click the arrow to move it back over to the left box. Then move all of the nominal and ordinal variables without a subscript A over to the right box. Click on the statistics button and uncheck mean, median, mode, and standard deviation. Since we are analyzing ordinal and nominal variables now, then click OK. Now you see all of your nominal and ordinal variables that were analyzed to your left side of the output screen below scale level variables that you analyzed. All of this descriptive data is often used to create a descriptive statistics chart, so your sample characteristics are neatly organized and summarized. Remember, you will be creating a descriptive statistics chart as part of this lab number 1 assignment. You can view a template for creating a descriptive statistics chart in the SPSS Lab Number 1 folder. You will interpret the findings from your analysis in the output file in order to answer the questions for this lab. Remember, the questions are located in the case scenario document in the SPSS Lab Number 1 folder on Blackboard. You will also need to conduct an analysis on the qualitative data by hand in your SPSS file. Remember, the qualitative data items are items in which the participants responded by writing in their own answers from their own point of view. If there are any variables that are qualitative in nature, items, usually other, in which participants wrote out responses, you must analyze that in Microsoft Word. In order to do that, go back to your SPSS data view screen. I have provided an example of this brief qualitative analysis for you here. Go to the qualitative variable and right-click that specific column of responses and copy. Then open up a Microsoft Word document and click Paste. Then group like responses together, which is the basis of content analysis. Here you see there are two distinct groups of topics that participants were interested in. The first responses are similar in some way, so I come up with a theme or variable that describes the responses in this first group. For example, I might call this first theme gangs, and then I would count the number of responses in this theme and write it as n equals 5. I would do the same for the second grouping and might title it substance use. In this example, participants were interested in learning more about gangs and substance abuse. You will follow this process to analyze data from two of the parent survey items. Remember to email yourself your data file and your output file so that you will always have a backup copy. Remember that even if you email it to yourself, the only computer you can open an SPSS output file on is a computer with SPSS software. Use the information from your output file to answer the questions on the case scenario for lab number one. You will submit your data file, output file, and answers to the lab questions on a Microsoft document for your grade for this lab. Again, submit your data file, output file, and put the answers to the lab questions on a Microsoft Word document for your grade for this lab. This concludes the instructions on analyzing data for Lab 1.